Okay. Good afternoon. Welcome to Kavita classes. Today you are studying about the main topic, that is immunity. It is very important chapter in the pharmaceutical biotechnology. So what is immune system of our body? So immune refers to the protection. Immune means, it is a Latin word. It means protection. The immune system of body is being built of protection against the attack by the foreign substances. So apart from our body substances, whenever the attack of foreign substances takes place in our body, that particular substance is called as the antigen. It may be, example, it may be viruses, it may be bacteria, or it may be any fungus or any microorganism. That foreign substance is called as the antigen. And whatever for the response to protect that, whatever it will release, that is called as the antibody. So immune system is working in the these two principles, that is the antigen attack and the antibody production. Immunity is defined as resistance to disease, especially infectious diseases. And immune system means the collection of cells and molecules that mediate to resistance to the infection is refers to the immune system. And immune response, the coordinated reaction of these cells and molecules, infection, microbes, is known as the immune response. These are the definition of the immunity, antigen, immune system and the immune response. So next, coming to the how the immune system works. So our immune system is able to differentiate between the substances that belong to our body, or it is either it is our body material or it is the foreign material. First, it will recognize that whether it is our body material or it is a foreign material, and it tries to, whenever it identifies as a foreign material, then it tries to eliminate from the body. So therefore, whenever the organ transplant surgery is done, therefore immunosuppressant medication is given in the for this reason, because whenever organ transplant is done, it will show as it is as a foreign material or foreign organism from the body. So for that, immune suppression drugs should be given. So basically, it is responsible for the immune system is WBC cells, white blood cells, or the lymphocytes. These are primarily responsible to defend our immune system. This recognizes specific antigens. Especially, it will recognize the specific antigen and it will change us as a foreign material or the our body material. So it will identify the responsible for the identification of the immune system and defend the immune system, especially lymphocytes and the WBC. In lymphocytes, two lymphocytes are there, majorly T lymphocytes and the B lymphocytes. So both are present in the tissues of our human body. They remain inactive until they recognize the specific antigen. Whenever they see the particular foreign antigen or foreign body, antigen means foreign body, whenever they recognize the specific antigen, the receptors on the surface of the lymphocytes, will bind with the antigen. Lymphocytes destroy the antigen. Immunosuppressant agents prevent the lymphocyte and the antigen from binding, therefore preventing the immune system from destroying the transplant and organs. So in this basic criteria, immunosuppressant criteria, it will work. Once the foreign antigen material it will recognize, it will start the lymphocytes, outer layer of the lymphocytes, receptors will bind to that antigen and it will stop the, or it will destroy that particular antigen. So this is the types of the immunity, majorly innate immunity or the adaptive immunity. Basically, by the biodiversity two types are there. In innate immunity, blood-borne immunity will be there, physical barriers will be there. Adaptive immunity, T cell and B cell. This is adaptive immunity is particular area or particular organism, organ is lymphocyte immunity. Or innate immunity is the basic one, complement cascade. So it will, how it will stop the, this chart is how it will stop the particularly antigen attack from the foreign or foreign substances attack from to the body. So next, other than this, cellular immunity is there and the humoral immunity is there. These are the majority types of the immunity. So what is cellular immunity? It is an adaptive immune response that is principally deliberated by thymus derived small lymphocytes. So basically in the cellular immunity, lymphocytic smaller cells are recognized, which are recognized as the T cells. They do not terminate the infected cells and pathogens. However, they trigger the direct further immune cells to do so. They usually directly they will not attack the antigens, but they will trigger the immune cells, other immune cells to block the antigen. Cellular immunity is a protective immune process that involves the activation of phagocytes, antigen-sensitive cytotoxic T cells, and the release of the cytokines, chemokines, and the in response to the antigen. So, by antigen-sensitive cytotoxic T cells will release some of the chemical reactions, that is cytokines, chemokines, and some of the antibodies. So, these responses will stop the antigen attack to the our cells. So, cellular immunity is most effective against the cell-infected viruses, particularly intracellular bacteria, fungi, protozoans, and the cancer cells. Especially, cell-mediated immunity is very useful in the cancer cell, and it is also in the transplant rejection. Next one is the humoral immunity. In this, proteins called immunoglobulins and antibodies will be there. Cellular immunity, it will be indirect immunity, but in the humoral immunity, the immunoglobulins will be there. Result in the production of the proteins called as the immunoglobulins or the antibodies. Body exposed to the foreign material termed as the antigen may be harmful to the body, that is viruses, bacteria. Antigen has passed by the other protective mechanisms, first and second line defenses. So this is the cell, it is entering to the our cell. This is the bacteria cell and it is entering to the cell. This is the picture of the humoral immunity. Some of the immunoglobulins and the antibodies will stop the production of the proteins. So classes of the immunoglobulins, so many classes are there. Majorly 5, immunoglobulin A, D, E, G, M. Other than that, differentiation of the heavy chains will be there. Usually in the length C region, location of the disulfide bond hinge region, distribution of the carbohydrates. So you can see in this picture, C region. So in this, disulfide bonds will be there and they will attach to the heavy chains, production of the differentiation of the heavy chains at the based on the heavy chains. So this is the differentiation of the these antibodies of the chain. One by one we will study. First one is IgG, immunoglobulin G. Usually structure will be monomer structure. This is the IgG structure. Percentage of the serum antibody is 80%. So IgG will be 80% of the body. It is 80% available. Location, blood, lymph, intestine. Half-life in serum is 23 days. So one IgG body will sustain around 23 days. Complement fixation is yes. Placental transfer is yes. So it will transfer through the placenta. Placental barrier also. Non-functions are, it will enhance the phagocytosis or cell eating. Phagocytosis means cell eating. Neutralizes the toxins, fiber, viruses, protects the fetus and the newborn. As it is, placental barrier transfer is yes in the, for this immunoglobulin. It protects the fetus and the newborn in the pregnant ladies. IgG antibody. Next one is the IgM. So structure is the pentamer structure, chemical structure. Percentage serum antibodies 5 to 10%. Location will be blood, lymph, B cell surface. Half-life in serum is 5 days. Complement fixation is yes. Placental transfer is no. So this is not acting on the fetus or newborn babies. Its function is, it is first antibody produced during an infection. So whenever the foreign body antigen attacks takes place, it is the first, IgM is the first antibody produced, effective against the microbes and agglutinating antigens. So it will act by the agglutination reaction of the antigen. So it will bind, it will give the complex form of the antigen and the antibody reactions. थर्ड इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन इज द IgA. इट इज अ डाइमर स्ट्रक्चर. परसेंटेज ऑफ द सीरम एंटीबॉडी 10 to 15. यूजुअली इट इज प्रेजेंट इन IgA एंटीबॉडी प्रेजेंट इन टीयर्स और टीयर्स सलाइवा इंटेस्टाइन एंड इन मिल्क ऑल्सो ब्लड और लिम्फ इट इज प्रेजेंट. हाफ लाइफ इन सीरम इज 6 days. Complementary fixation no, placental transfer is no. So its function is it protects the mucosal surfaces, our outer surfaces, whatever the mucosal layer of the eye, because it is present in the tear, it is present in the saliva, so it will protect the all the mucosal layers of the body and it provides the immunity to infant digestive tract. So smaller children digestive tract. As it is present in the saliva, it will give the immunity to the digestive tract. Fourth immunoglobulin is the IgB. So structure is monomer. Percentage of the serum antibodies is 0.2%. Location is usually blood and lymph B cells. Half life in serum is 3 days. Complement fixation no. Placental transfer is no. Its function is unknown. Actually, IgD immunoglobulin is unknown. It is having the unknown function. Still, it is researchers have not shown any particular function for this immunoglobulin. Next is IgE. IgE usually monomer structure. It is very small quantity is present in the our body antibodies serum. 0.002%. Usually bound in the mast cells, basophils throughout the body, in the blood. Half life also very short, 2 days. Placental transfer no, and complementary fixation is no. So it functions will be, it is very useful in the allergic reactions, IgE immunoglobulin, and possibly in the lysis of the worms. So it will kill the worms. Classes of the other classes of the immunoglobulins are usually additional classification usually from the light chain. Heavy chain will be immunoglobulins, 5 immunoglobulins A, E, G, B, M. And in the light chain, kappa immunoglobulins will be there, lambda immunoglobulins will be there. So immunoglobulins G has kappa, lambda or both. So IgG kappa will be there, IgG lambda will also be there. This is the other class, lighter chain immunoglobulins. Next is the IgE and IgD antibodies of the immune response. These are very main antibodies. IgE immunoglobulins binds with the high affinity to the receptors on the mast cells, basophils and the activated eosinophils. Longer half-life when cell bonds initiates a strong inflammatory action to parasites. It is used in the allergic reactions. So, inflammation, cell inflammation reactions for the parasites, worms, and for the activation of the eosinophils in the IgE antibody immunoglobulins is required. IgD, it is receptor on the matured B cells, no other known function. So, IgD, as I told, it has still research is going on. Next is the histocompatibility complex, MHC. What is MHC? Major histocompatibility complex. So it is defined as a set of genes that code for cell surface protein essential for the acquired immune system. So this is the genetic response or genetic code, set of genetic code which can be bind to the cell surface to acquire the immune system is called as the major histocompatibility complex, as a genetic code and the cell surface is co-joining and it will give the immune responses and it will recognize the foreign molecules in vertebrates. In turn, discipline of three types, majorly three types of the MHC are there, class 1, class 2 and class 3. These are the major histocompatibility complexes. So what are the function of the MHC? Usually it binds to the endogenous antigens present in the T helper cells, that is thymus helper cells. They are found on the surface of the all nucleated cells. They are secreted proteins possessing immune functions. They are also involved in the complementary activation. Inflammation caused by the cytokines, tumors, necrosis factors. So it is majorly used in the tumor cells lysis and the inflammation caused by the cytokine reactions. MHC is the other part of the immunity. Next is the hypersensitivity. So what is hypersensitivity? Hypersensitivity refers to having an extreme sensitivity or simulation of the senses. So hypersensitivity means whatever our senses are there, touch sense, sight, hearing, taste and smell. These are the sensitivity of the human being. So hypersensitivity means extreme sensitivity to the senses. This is the hypersensitivity. So the children who suffers from the hypersensitivity may complain sensory stimuli will be more compared to the others. They also find impossible to regulate the emotional behavioral response of the higher level sensory stimulation. For example, if you hug the child, the child may lose the temper. So this is the hypersensitivity reactions by the immunoglobulins, the hypersensitivity of the child. It is called as the hypersensitivity behavior or emotional behavior of the child. So what are the causes of the hypersensitivity? There are several known causes of the hypersensitivity in children, including sensory processing disorders, sensory integration disorders may be there. Other than that, autism will be there. Neurological disorders may be there, peripheral neuropathy may be there, traumatic brain injury if happens to anybody, not only child, also adults, traumatic brain injury, fibromyalgia, structural abnormality in any of the sensory systems, having a deviated septum, damage to any one of the sensory system, damage to your auditory system caused by the overexposure to loud or noise. If you expose more loud and noise, also sometimes auditory senses will go. For that also damage to sensory system, that also gives the hypersensitivity of the human being. In addition, hypersensitivity in children, other than that, this fragile X syndrome, Down syndrome, cerebral palsy and epilepsy, these are the some of the hypersensitivity, and also obsessive compulsive disorder. This is also anxiety disorders, obsessive compulsive disorders. These are the some of the disorders or diseases stage where hypersensitivity can be seen. Other than this, four types of majorly hypersensitivity reactions are there. One is the type 1 hypersensitivity, that is immediate reaction. So if any foreign antigen hits to our body, typical allergic reactions, immediate reactions, that are the type 1 hypersensitivity reaction. Second one is type 2 cytotoxic and the cell bound antibody reaction. Antibody binding to the target cells alter the function, death, activate, inhibit. So it may be death, it may cause also death. So type 2 hypersensitivity is severe and effect is antibody immediately activated. So once the foreign again reaction will take place in the T cells lymphocytes, antibody mediated reaction will be taking place. Type 3 will be soluble antibody immune complexes. So here antigen antibody complexes float around the activated immune system. Type 3 will be soluble. Type 4 cell mediated, again it will be end effect will be T cell mediated antibody will be given. So these are the four types majorly of the hypersensitivity. Type 1 immediate, type 2 cell toxic, type 3 cell soluble antibody immune complexes, type 4 is the cell mediated, particular T cell mediated reaction will be there. In this all antibody reactions, antigen antibody, this is the stages of the reactions where the hypersensitivity will be takes place. So by based on the stages of the reaction where the hypersensitivity is takes place, the four types of the hypersensitivity is seen. Next is the immune suppression. So what is immune suppression? It is reduction of the activation of the or efficacy of the immune system. So we are suppressing our immune system for the response. For especially I told this, or in the organ transplants, once the transplant surgery is done, it will show as the foreign material or foreign body as the transplanted organs. So for that we need to suppress our immune system. For that immune suppression medication is given. So in this immune suppression, two types of the immune suppressions are there. One is the deliberately induced immune suppression. Second one is the non-deliberate immune suppression. So deliberated one, it occurs in case medication during the organ transplantation. Simple one. Second one is non-deliberated one, especially in the cancer, chronic infection and the HIV cases. Non-deliberated immunosuppression is necessary. Next is the vaccines. So vaccines, so many vaccine preparations are there in this syllabus. I am giving some of the vaccines: cholera vaccine, BCG vaccine, diphtheria, polio, and the tetanus vaccine. So cholera vaccine, or it is a bacterial vaccine. Cholera is a serious infection which is caused by the Sprengium vibrio cholerae. Cholera vaccine is homogeneous suspension which is prepared from the kill vibrio strain. So we are killing the vaccines. Two types are there. One is the killed vaccine, one is the attenuated vaccine. So this is the killed vaccine. Cholera vaccine is the killed vaccine. We are killing the vibrio cholerae specimen strain having antigen efficacy and the purity. So we will take that antigen very purely and efficiently. Category, it is an active immunizing agent. Initial dose will be 0.5 ml, second dose will be 1 ml. Storage of temperature 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Almost all vaccines will be kept in a cool temperature 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Next one is the BCG vaccine. It is also suspension of living cells. It is not the kill cells, which is obtained from the Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which is known as Bacillus Camete Guerin. BCG, Bacillus Camete Guerin. BCG vaccine is a live freeze-dried vaccine. So it is attenuated vaccine type. We are not killing the antigen, but we are not killing the bacteria. We are taking, by living bacteria, we are taking the same antigen species. Live freeze-dried vaccine is used for prevention for the tuberculosis. It is a freeze-dried preparation in dark. It should be kept in a dark room, because it is light sensitive, 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Should be protected from the light. Single dose will be 0.1 ml. Next vaccine is the diphtheria vaccine. It is a diphtheria is a communicable disease which is caused by the Cornibacterium diphtheria, which colonizes and forms a pseudomembrane of the infection site. Diphtheria toxin is synthesized and secreted as a single polypeptide chain, which is having A chain and the B chain. It is having two chains. It is an active immunizing agent. It is initial dose is 0.5 ml, second dose is 0.5, 4 weeks third dose again 0.5. So 0.5 is the dose. It should not contain more than 30 LF of diphtheria toxoid per dose. So 0.5 ml. Its temperature also same, 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Next is the polio vaccine. Polio is a live oral aqueous suspension. It is obtained from the attenuated strains of polio myelitis virus. There are the three distinct antigen types, polio myelitis types 1, 2, 3, and each has much greater antigen stability. It should be stored in sealed tight resistance container, because it is oxidation will take place to this at a temperature between 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. It has a potency not less than 2.5 units for each dose. It is a freeze-dried powder or pellets which is reconstituted with the suitable solvent. Last vaccine preparation is the tetanus vaccine. Tetanus antotoxin is a liquid preparation which is containing specific antotoxin globulins which are obtained from the hyper immune system. So it is taken hyper immune system of horse, other suitable animals. We are taking from that animals and we are injecting to the human beings. This liquid preparation contains suitable antimicrobial preservatives. So it is a passive immunizing agent. It should be given to a subcutaneous and intramuscular injection, SC and IM injection. It should be kept in a 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. It is freeze-dried, pale yellow liquid, cream color powder and the pellets. So these are the some of the general methods for the preparation of the some of the vaccines, its storage condition and the other conditions also. Next is the hybridoma technology. So what is hybridoma technology? It's a method for producing large number of the identical antibodies. It is a genetical engineering method, hybridoma technology, hybridization, to create a hybrid of the any plant or animal. Hybridoma technology, it is a cell, hybridoma of the cell also sometimes it is done. So it is a method for producing large number of the identical antibodies. So especially in the immune system, we are producing the antibodies called as monoclonal antibodies. It was discovered by G. Kohler, C. Milstein in 1975. They were awarded Nobel Prize for the Physiology and the Medicine in 1975 for the this discovery, hybridoma technology, identical monoclonal identical antibodies, large number production, that is called as the monoclonal antibodies. So these are very identical antibodies. The hybrid cells are produced by the fusing the B lymphocytes, myeloma cells and the tumor cells. So hybrid cells are prepared for this reason. It is named as a hybridoma technology. The B cell lymphocytes have an ability to produce large number of antibodies. Tumor cells have indefinite growth. So by joining this, we are taking the hybrid cells. This is why two cells are used for the production of the hybrid cells. So we are taking the two cells function. So beta lymphocyte cell function, B lymphocyte cell functions and also tumor cell function. You are getting both the function in a hybrid cell. So because of that, we are combining that B lymphocyte cell and the tumor cell to get the hybrid cell. So procedure will be, specially mouse is immunized by the specific antigen injection against the monoclonal antibodies have to be produced. So first mouse injection to be done in the specific antigen. After 72 hours, immunization screen is collected. So once the specific antigen is injected, the mouse immune system will produce some of the antibodies. That antibody producing B cells, after 72 hours it will produce the antibody. We are taking from the spleen, that antibodies we are collecting from the spleen. The beta cells are fused with the immortalized myeloma cells by the polyethyl glycol and the sender viruses. So again it is kept in the polyethyl glycol medium. Next, beta cells are fused in the immortalized myeloma cells. Again, it is fused with the cells. The fused cells are incubated in the hybridoma technology medium. So this is the flow chart. Immunization of the mouse to stimulate the antibody production. So specific antigen is injected to the mouse. Antibody forming cells isolated from the spleen. By this injection, we are collecting the sample. So once this spleen antibody is taken place, this is the again fusing of the tumor cells growing in the tissue sensor. These are the tumor cells and this is the beta lymphocyte antibody. These are fused, so co-joined. This is the given the one of another cell. This is the hybrid cell, you can see. So these hybrid cells again injected, hybridoma screened for the antibody production. So again this is large number of, it is again cultivated. So once the cultivation is, antibody production is done, again hybridoma is screened again for the antibody. So antibody produced, you can see, again this antibody is removed, hybridoma screened from the antibody, removed from the cell. You can see here antibodies seen. This is also another flowchart. Tumor cells are injected to a mouse stimulate production of the B cell, which produces the type of the anti-tumor antibodies. So these are the antibodies and the beta cells. These are the myeloma cells and the myeloma cells. Again, these are co-joined. You can see here. Again, hybrid cells are taken place. Hybrid cells are, third one is fused with the myeloma cells. So here they are fused to get a hybrid cell. Again, hybrid cells producing needed to, it will give the antibody cloned cells and the monoclonal. It is taken as a monoclonal antibodies. So this is about the hybridoma technology. Hybridoma technology. To get this hybridoma screen for the antibody procedure, the medium is required. For that, polyethyl glycol is used. Application of the HLT is, it is used for the early detection of the pregnancy, especially detection and treatment of the cancer, diagnosis of the leprosy, treatment of the autoimmune diseases. Radio-labeled monoclonal antibodies is used for the in vivo detection or localization of the tumor antigen, used for making immunotoxins and inhibits the protein synthesis. Example of HAT will be usually diphtheria toxin, shigella toxin and the resin. These are the some of the 4 to 5 application of the hybridoma technology. So for more videos, subscribe to the Kovitra Classes channel. This is about the immunity chapter. Thank you.